In this module, we'll take a look at collections. First, I will explain what a collection is and what types of collections are available. Then, I will teach you how to add, manipulate, and modify collections to display any kind of content. So, what is a collection? A collection is used to present multiple items in a single interactive context. As we discussed in the Composer Layout module, there are three collection style categories. Layout collections, which give you total control over the spatial organization of contained items. Ordered collections, which assign a visual order to contained items and can have a notion of items in focus. And dimensional collections, which display items in a map or in a timeline. Regardless of the style, collections can contain any combination of assets and other collections. You could put asset grids inside groups, inside asset grids. Probably not a good idea visually, but you can do it. Aside from the slideshow collection, which is fully automated, collections are interactive, enabling users to browse collection content via tap and swipe gestures. In addition, aside from the group, pinboard, scroll, and slideshow collections, content can be popped out for further interaction via tap and drag and drop gestures. We'll see how to do that in a later module. Let's play with a collection. First, let's open the Collections panel in Composer by clicking its icon. Then, we'll select the collection we want to use by either clicking on it, which will place it in the middle of the scene, or drag and drop onto part of the canvas in which we'd like it to go. Let's say I want to play around with the asset grid. I'll click it so it appears in my scene. Notice how the asset grid didn't just appear in the canvas, it also showed up in the scene structure panel. Once the asset grid is dropped onto the scene, I can resize and move it or change its properties like this. There's nothing more boring than an empty collection. Collections exist to display content. Like, maybe you want to show a product catalog or the latest videos from your favorite YouTube channel. As a simple example, let's pick the YouTube channel idea. We'll go back to the Assets panel, find the YouTube asset, and drag it onto the asset grid. As an alternative, I could have added it to my scene and then used the Scene Structure panel to drag it onto the asset grid. Once the YouTube asset is nested inside the asset grid, I can customize its appearance using the Properties panel. Now, what if we want more than one video? Just drag and drop more YouTube assets onto the asset grid, or select the first YouTube asset and duplicate it multiple times. Either way, I then need to update these YouTube assets with the proper video URL. Good news! One of the biggest advantages of collections is their capacity to include different types of assets. For instance, here I'm creating an asset grid that contains video assets, image assets, and document assets, all at the same time. Remember my comment about nesting groups inside asset grids inside groups? Let me show you what I mean about nesting collections. Let's say I want to display the same items in multiple layouts. I'll place an empty group collection inside our asset grid. Add the desired assets onto the group. And finally, duplicate this group twice. By doing so, I've created a total of three group collections. All I have to do now is rearrange the position, size, layout of each item inside each group so they all have a different design. I'll leave it to you to try putting an asset grid into the group. Done! You've now had a front row seat to all the basics for collections. Now it's your turn to try.